Hello everyone, today we will start the sequence of name reactions of organic chemistry. First of all, for any name reactions, we must know these four things: the substrate, the reagent, the product, and the mechanism. As you all know, substrate is the molecule on which the reaction will occur, reagent are the chemicals that we will add for the reaction to initiate, and the product are the final molecules that are formed. And the very important thing is the mechanism. The mechanism of any organic reaction is very important, because with the help of mechanism only you can know the RDS, the stereochemistry, and other important things. And for name reactions, it is very important that we must identify the reaction. For the simpler questions, we can directly do with the help of tricks, and we can directly make product. But for complex questions which involve different kinds of functional groups in it, we must know the mechanism, how it works. Okay, so today we will start with Beckmann rearrangement. Beckmann rearrangement, as the name suggests, it's a type of rearrangement, and very importantly, it's a type of intramolecular rearrangement. An intramolecular rearrangement is a type of rearrangement in which the groups migrate within the molecule, or everything will happen within the molecule. Now, the substrate is oxime, the product is an amide. For those who don't know what is an oxime is a compound in which a nitrogen is attached to a doubly bonded carbon on one side and to an OH on the other side. And product is an amide. Everyone knows what is an amide. C double bond O, N, R, you can add an H. This is a primary structure of an amide. And the reagent used is a dehydrating agent or a Lewis acid. The most common reagent that you will get everywhere is H+, from H2SO4. It will be taken in catalytic amount. And other reagents that you will get are PCl5, TSCl, SOCl2, POCl3. They will work mostly as dehydrating agent. The main purpose of the reagent, as we will get to know in the reaction, is to convert this OH group into a good leaving group so that it can leave. Now, very important thing about this reaction is its stereochemistry. Stereochemistry is the group anti to OH will migrate because its anti-bonding orbital is near to that group. You might not get it what I am telling you now, but when we will do the mechanism, we'll make it clear. Now, first of all, simple nomenclature. This is a stereo center. It can show geometrical isomerism, and the OH group. The group opposite to OH is anti to OH, and the group on the same side of OH is syn to OH. So, this OH group, this bond is made up of a bonding molecular orbital, and we all know with every bonding molecular orbital there exists an anti-bonding molecular orbital, and everything we will be discussing in the mechanism would be related to this anti-bonding molecular orbital. The main important thing is the group anti to OH will migrate. You must remember this: the group anti to OH, that is opposite to OH, will migrate. And if the stereochemistry is not mentioned, that is if the compound is like given like this, where you don't know what is the stereochemistry. So we will follow the order of migratory aptitude. You must have known study rearrangement reaction, then most of the rearrangement reaction except the Baer-Williger oxidation, the migratory aptitude is hydrogen, then phenyl, then 3 degree, then 2 degree, then 1 degree. Now let's look at the mechanism. Let's draw an oxime, an OH group, a carbon, and R1 and R2. See, for simplicity we will be taking H+. It's the for writing mechanism it's the easiest. Anything you will take, the mechanism will be same. Now, we said that the reagent we are adding is to convert this OH group into a good leaving group. So the lone pair of OH will attack. See, this is an electrophile, this is a nucleophile, and every organic reaction occurs like that. The combination of an electrophile and a nucleophile. OH, H, oxygen has three bonds. It doesn't want to have a positive charge on it. It's a highly electronegative element. So it will either take the electrons from hydrogen or take the electrons from nitrogen. If it takes the electrons from hydrogen, the reaction will go backward. Nothing will happen. So it has to take the electrons from nitrogen. So this bond will shift here. Since it is eliminating a neutral water molecule, therefore OH2 plus, we all know, is a very good leaving group. So water molecule is taken out, and as the water molecule is taken out, there will be a development of a positive charge on nitrogen. And you all know nitrogen is a very electronegative element. It will not bear a positive charge on it. So as soon as this OH2, this water molecule is eliminated, the group anti-2OH, I said you anti-2OH, this here it's R1. So this R1 will migrate like this. The actually what the thing is happening is R1, this is the carbon. So I am showing it like this. It's happening like this. Carbon is positive, R1 is negative, and now this negative charge is going on. Nitrogen is having positive. See, for those who didn't understand this, this is for them. So it migrates. So here there is a development of positive charge. Let's write it. R1, a lone pair. Sorry, it will be R2. Yeah. Now many of you would think that a carbocation has been formed on sp2 carbon. It would be very unstable. It will not survive, but it will not be formed. But the thing is, although it has been formed on an sp2 carbon, there is a nitrogen having lone pair, and which will stabilize this carbocation with the help of back bonding. And you all know back bonding stabilizes carbocation and are highly stable. You must have learnt about SIDM carbocation and Friedel-Crafts reaction. That too is a back bonding stabilized carbocation. See, nitrogen R1, nitrogen has four bonds, positive charge. See, these are resonating structures. We made them in a box. Now, see, now there is a electrophile generated. We had the water molecule eliminated. It will act as a nucleophile. Organic reactions are nothing but electrophile and nucleophile reacting with each other in different type of scenarios. See, nitrogen, a lone pair, an R1, an R2, an O, H, H. Now oxygen has positive charge. It's a highly electronegative element. It has to become neutral. So it will either pull electrons from carbon or from hydrogen. If it pulls electron from carbon, it will again go in backward direction. We don't want to go it in backward direction. We want it to move it in forward direction. So it will pull its electrons from hydrogen. So see, the H plus that was in the reaction, that was given in the reaction, has now again been eliminated. So here H plus is acting as a catalyst. The entire thing is happening within the molecule. That's why we said it's an intramolecular rearrangement. OH. Now comes the step. You can see there is an ene and an OH. Enol. You must have learned about ketoenol tautomerism. It is very similar to that, because an O and C double bond O carbon is a C double bond O bond is very stable and is very highly thermodynamically stable. It will be favored to form. So we can undergo, it can undergo tautomerization. Tautomerization. See, it's very simple. 1, 2, 3. The hydrogen will shift its electron to this, and this bond pair will undergo will become a lone pair, and this lone pair will attack the hydrogen. R2, N, H, and R1. See, this is an amide. We started from an oxime, ended up in an amide. So we understood that in the Beckmann rearrangement, it is an intramolecular rearrangement in which we will start with an oxime, put the reagent such as a Lewis acid or a dehydrating agent, and we will get amide. As simple as that. Now what I was talking about is stereochemistry. You see, when this group is migrating, the question arises, why did this group only migrate and this didn't? The answer was that this NO bond is formed of a molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital, you must have learned in inorganic chemistry. And for every bonding molecular orbital, there exists an anti-bonding molecular orbital. And we know when the electrons go to anti-bonding molecular orbital, then the bonding molecular becomes empty. So as this, and since you can see, we have R1 group and R2 group, all these are in one plane. So when this, so R1 group is more near to this antibonding molecular orbital, so it can migrate easily. If R2 had to migrate, it was far from here. So since it was far from here, the migration would have been difficult. That is the reason the group anti-2 OH group will migrate. Now you get it.